Most people probably know the story of Romeo and Juliet, but in reality, we've been looking at it wrong the entire time. In reality, it's about a reckless, young, narcissistic teenager and how his consequences led to both his and his 13-year-old wife's death. Let me explain. A few days after falling in love with Juliet, Romeo's friend Mercutio was killed by Tybalt, Juliet's cousin. This gave Romeo the idea that he could avenge his friend by going and fighting Tybalt to the death. Some would say that he fought Tybalt in an act of defense, but I severely have to argue with that. You see, when Romeo and Tybalt found each other, Romeo verbally assaulted Tybalt and said that at least one of them must die by the end of this, stating that he knew that somebody was going to die to begin with, and he came in with the intent of killing or dying. After that, Romeo fled the scene. Knowing that he'd killed someone, he felt a lot of guilt and knew that he would be in harm if he stayed there. Another reason he may have killed Tybalt is that he acts irrationally and immediately acts upon his emotions. This is how he started to like Juliet after just meeting her, and married her after just a few days. After all these facts, we can declare that Romeo should be put into a prison and thrown off the soundstage onto the ground. Or, in other words, he should be getting 25 years in prison at the very least, according to American law. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. It's for a project I have in English, and because I wanted you to take some part in the opinion that you have in this, I set up a poll on my channel. Go to that section, and you too can vote whether or not Romeo is guilty. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.